गुड आफ्टरनून चिल्ड्रेन, वेलकम बैक टू मैथमेटिक्स क्लास, चैप्टर 11, ट्रिग्नोमेट्री, पार्ट 9. इन टुडेज क्लास यू आर गोइंग टू लर्न द आइडेंटिटीज, ट्रिग्नोमेट्रिक आइडेंटिटीज एंड द सम. ओनली वन सम इज एक्सप्लेन्ड फ्रॉम एक्सरसाइज 11.4 एंड अलोंग विद द आइडेंटिटीज, हाउ द आइडेंटिटीज हैव डिराइव्ड ज्योमेट्रिकली. That one identity is also explained in this. So let us move on to the content. So trigonometric identities. Consider a right triangle, which is right angled at B. A angle A and angle C are acute angles. So by Pythagoras theorem, we will get here AB square plus BC square is equal to AC square. Now divide each term of the above equation by AC square. Then we will get here AB square by AC square, BC square by AC square is equal to AC square by AC square. Now, with respect to angle A, what is sine A formula? Opposite by hypotenuse, that means BC by AC. So sine A is BC by AC. What is sine A whole square? Sine A whole square is sine square A, and here the right hand side will get BC square by AC square. This is equation 2. Now, what is cos A with respect to angle A? Adjacent, that is AB by hypotenuse, that is AB by AC. Now, what is cos A whole square? That is cos square A, and square this AB by AC whole square, that is called AB square by AC square. This is equation 3. Now what you have to do, substitute equation 2 and equation 3 in equation 1. Okay, that is when you substitute equation 2 in equation 1 in place of BC square by AC square, you should write sine square A. And equation 3 is nothing but in place of AB square by AC square, you must write here cos square A. And in place of BC square by AC square, you must write sine square A. And the RHS is AC square by AC square. That value is 1. So finally, we'll get here cos square A plus sine square A is equal to 1. Similarly, we can find the other two identities also the same way only. You can refer the textbook. So if you have any doubts, you can call me. So wherever, when you solve the sum, in exercise, that means the sums from exercise 11.4. So wherever the necessary is there, that means wherever you get sine square A, cos square A, you have plus sine square A plus cos square A. In place of that, you can write directly 1. This is one of the identity. So what is the identity? Cos square A plus sine square A is equal to 1. Or reverse order also no problem, because it's plus sine square A plus cos square A is also equal to 1 only. Now, let us see all the three identities. Sine square theta plus cos square theta is equal to 1. Secant square theta minus tan square theta is equal to 1. Cosecant square theta minus cot square theta is equal to 1. These three are the three identities which you'll use in exercise 11.4 to solve the sums. Once again, first identity is sin square theta plus cot square theta is equal to 1. Second identity is secant square theta minus tan square theta is equal to 1. And the third identity is cosecant square theta minus cot square theta is equal to 1. Now, from this first identity, so cos square A plus sin square A is equal to 1, we can get it two more identities. That is, if you transpose cos square A that side, then you get sin square A is equal to 1 minus cos square A. So this also you can use it for solving the sum of exercise 11.4. Then, suppose when you transpose sin square A to the other side of 1, then we get cos square A is equal to 1 minus sin square A. These two we got it from the first identity. Now see the second identity. Secant square A minus tan square A is equal to 1. From this identity, we can get two more. That is, secant square A is equal to transpose this minus tan square A to the right hand side. It will change to plus. So 1 plus tan square A. So tan square, secant square A is equal to 1 plus tan square A. Now, tan square A you want it. That means, what you must do? First you transpose secant square A the other side, you will get 1 minus secant square A. minus tan square A is equal to 1 minus secant square A. So this minus tan square A multiplied with minus, similarly right hand side part also multiplied with minus, then you get tan square A is equal to secant square A minus 1. These two we got it from this identity. That is secant square A is equal to 1 plus tan square A, and tan square A is equal to secant square A minus 1. Let us see the third identity. Cosecant square A minus cot square A is equal to 1. From this identity, we get two more. That is, cosecant square A is equal to simply transpose minus cot square A the other side. We get 1 plus cot square A. Now, cot square A is equal to, that means, first transpose cosecant square A other side, and you get 1 minus cosecant square A. So here, minus cot square A is there. Change this minus into plus by multiplying it with minus. So minus into minus will become plus. So plus cot square A is equal to, this plus 1 changes to minus, so right, minus 1. And this minus cosecant square A changes to plus, so that is plus cosecant square A. So cot square A is equal to cosecant square A minus 1. So these are the three identities. Along with three, we have two more. That means each identity, we got two more identities. Totally, we have 9. So these 9 you must remember for solving the sums of exercises. 11.4. Let us see one question from exercise 11.4. Evaluate the following. The first one is 1 plus tan theta plus secant theta into 1 plus cot theta minus secant theta. 1 plus, you can write tan theta as sin theta by cos theta, plus secant theta as 1 by 4 cos theta, because secant theta is the multiplicative inverse of cos. So that's why we can write secant theta as 1 by next, 1 plus cot theta is reciprocal of tan, that means cos by sin. So we can write in place of sin by cos, we'll write it cos theta by sin theta, minus cosecant theta is the multiplicative inverse of sin, so we'll write here minus 1 by sin theta. Now what you must do is, here 1 means, we can write 1 can be written as 1 by 1. Now what is the LCM for the denominator? 1, cos theta and cos theta. 2 times the same cos theta is repeated. So the LCM is cos theta. Okay. So write cos theta, now cross multiply. 1 into cos theta, which is cos theta. Already denominator, here LCM, both are same. So you'll write directly the sin theta here. So write sin theta. Plus, here the denominator, here the LCM, again both are same. So directly you can write the numerator here. That is, numerator is 1. So write 1. So this part is computed through the bracket for this. Now see the next part. Here also 1, nothing but 1 by 1. 1 sin theta, sin theta. The same for sin theta is 1 sin theta. So write sin theta. Again cross multiply 1 into sin theta, which is sin theta first numerator. Second numerator is this denominator and this LCM both are same. So we'll write cos theta as a second numerator. Third one is, here again sin theta, this denominator, this LCM both are same. So again we'll write only the numerator, what is there in the question, that only variable is minus 1. Now, after getting like this, if you observe here, this is cos theta plus sin theta, this is sin theta plus cos theta, both are same. So then 1 plus 2 and 2 plus 1, both are same. What is 1 plus 2 value? 3. What is 2 plus 1 value? It is also 3. That means cos theta plus sin theta or sin theta plus cos theta, both are same only. So that's why we'll assume now cos theta plus sin theta value as some A and this one as some B, variable B. Now, if you observe here, this complete one is A, means A plus B, and this into, this complete one is A minus B. So, this denominator, you just leave it like that only. I'm just changing only the numerators by using the identity. So, here we can use the identity A plus B into A minus B is equal to A square minus B square. What we assumed as A, that is cos theta plus sin theta. So, cos theta plus sin theta square, that is A square, means cos theta plus sin theta whole square, minus B. B, what we have assumed, 1, this 1 square. By, what is the denominator there? Cos theta into sin theta. Both denominators, we multiply cos theta into sin theta, because we are multiplying both. Now, again, this part, cos theta plus sin theta whole square, you must expand it, this one, by using the identity A plus B whole square. This would be A square plus 2AB plus B square. So, cos theta plus sin theta whole square expanded, A square, that means cos theta whole square. Cos theta whole square is nothing but cos square theta plus 2AB. this 2 into a plus cos theta is a, near b plus sin theta is a, so 2 cos theta sin theta plus b square, that means sin theta whole square. That is nothing but sin square theta. This is equation 2 and this is equation 1. Now, substitute equation 2 in equation 1. That means in place of cos theta plus sin theta whole square, you write this one expanded form of cos theta plus sin theta whole square. That is cos square theta plus 2 cos theta sin theta plus sin square theta, and put them in brackets. Minus 1 you write as it is, but denominator is cos theta sin theta. Now you see here. Now this sin square theta you write here. We are not transposing. Remember children, this completely, this is the same expression which is on the same side only. Okay, so we are just writing the second, third term. The third term we are writing it as second term. The terms we are interchanging, not transposing. Remember, so signs won't change. So cos square theta. Then I wrote here sin square theta plus here I wrote third term. That is second term as third term. It is 2 cos theta sin theta minus 1. Why I wrote? Because this is nothing but this is one of the identity, and its value is 1. Cos square theta plus sin square theta value is what? 1. So in place of this, write 1. So 1 plus 2 cos theta sin theta. So write 2 cos theta sin theta. Remove the brackets. We have already simplified it. Minus 1, right? Minus 1. Now this plus 1, this minus 1 are cancelled. Then here left over is 2 cos theta sin theta by cos theta sin theta. Both are under product, children. You see there. Whether 2 into 3 or 3 into 2, both the products are same. 2 into 3, how much? 6. 3 into 2 also, 6. That means sin theta into cos theta or cos theta into sin theta, both products are same. Cancel both. So what is left over? 2. So the answer is 2. In this way, you have to use the identities. You have to simplify the sums. Evaluate means remember that you will get only the numerical value. So here we got only 2. So my dear children, you practice all the identities first, and from the each identity, again two more identities are given. That also practice it, because those 6 identities, I mean not 6, 9, total 9 identities are very, very important for solving the sums of exercise 11.4. The first time I already explained it. Practice that sum also very well, and until you get these identities and the sum from exercise 11.4, please you practice and write it one time, that is as the assignment. And how the cos square theta plus sin square theta is equal to 1, which is explained by geometrically, it is explained once again. You re-watch it, but you will understand more. But it's not difficult, it's easier. So children, thank you very much. Thank you, one and all.